You're listening to Empathica Radio, home to unsigned metal, hardcore, and punk artists. The true underground.
Hail to the king, baby.
So I'm going to apologize for fucking up the last episode.
Yep.
I should have named all three episodes last month. technical difficulty part one, part two, part three. That's what I should have done because I fucked that up majorly. We had to wipe the entire backwards song.
Yes.
Because I forgot to add the line on this new interface. So it didn't pick up the music at all. All you could hear is our dumb asses talking about it and just blank sound when we're listening to it. So it was like, luckily I'm able to edit that out and put the episode together half-assed to where I just had to cut that section out. So I apologize. Hopefully I got this figured out now, which I probably don't.
Nope.
And that's just the way it is.
You could have gone back and put all the songs on a different track. Well, no, because you're skipping forward and back.
Yeah.
Because
I had talked to Mike about that. I had said, that's exactly what he said. He goes, you could just added the songs in. I'm like, oh, I guess I could have. But then, if I was talking about playing it backward, like, oh, let's go back or I'm going to jump. I guess I could have just made it up.
Yeah.
Who knew? I mean, who knew what it was?
Yeah.
You don't know what I'm talking about. But so the next one will hopefully work. And it's funny, though. I'm sitting there in the editing process, and I'm like doing everything, and all of a sudden it gets to that part, and I'm listening to it, and it gets in. All right, I'm going to play the first one, and it's just silent. And I'm like, what the fuck's going on? And you're like, oh, I don't know. And I'm like, what the fuck? And I'm like, what the hell happened? And then I'm looking right at the monitor, and I realize that there's no third line since I finally got an interface where I can separate these fucking microphones and I can edit individual mics now. We used to just dump into one fucking track no matter how many mics we had, which made it hard when Brennan's being quiet. Then I can't up the audio because it ups everything. But now I can. And that's where I fucked up. I was like, well, who needs that third line for the other microphone? So hopefully that's all fixed.
And also that last episode was quieter in general.
Was it?
Yeah.
Was quieter in general.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know about that.
Yeah, okay.
I don't know how I fix that. Oh, you know what? I think I remember messing with the levels. It sounded like it didn't. When I was like listening back to it, it almost sounded like it was clipping a bunch. So I might have lowered the level trying to stop that.
Yeah.
And it just made it quieter on accident. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm not a fucking professional, Brendan. That's what we need. We need actually somebody that knows what they're doing to edit these episodes and come here and actually record us and produce us. That's what we need. Because we don't know what we're doing. A couple of amateurs. I'll start accepting resumes.
Can I apply for the position?
No.
Aw.
Sorry. Unless you really want to.
How much does it pay?
Zero.
Damn it.
This is a internship. This is an internship. So I was at the, I went to Total Wine and Liquor. Is that the name of it? The new one. In Fairview.
Total Wine and More?
Yeah, that one. Something like that. So I had a gift card for my birthday from all the way back then that I forgot I had. I was like, I need to get beer for the show. So we went there yesterday, and I found something that I think you may enjoy. I say may because I think part of it you would maybe, but then the other one, the other part of it you might not. Hand you the bottle. I'm going to let you take a look at it and read it. Got it?
Yep. Excel. Bruja. Pumpkin ale aged in tequila barrels. See, pumpkin's good. I'm not sure about tequila.
So that's how I feel.
Yeah.
So tequila is the only thing that I don't mind taking shots of.
Oh.
But I don't do it all the time. But, I mean, if you had to tell me you had to do a shot of something, I'd probably do tequila.
Yeah.
I'm not a big shot person anyways. So, but that one I will do. But I still am not looking forward to that in this. I just imagine it not tasting very good. The bourbon barrel stuff, which I don't like bourbon, so that makes sense. It like makes me cringe when I taste it.
Oh,
like, you know, it's just not me. I don't like it.
I mean, I don't like it, but it's not bad.
Yeah, I hate bourbon. I hate whiskey. I hate the taste of it that much. I do not want to have any part of it. Yes, and there is a wax
seal
on it, like it's important, which I'm sure it's not.
How do you get it off? Just
I don't know.
Use
I've never.
Fingers?
I guess.
Yeah. Comes off with your fingernail.
Okay. It seems like a lot of extra money you're wasting. Is it not coming off? You need a key or something?
It's probably not a twist-off top, though.
No, I got a bottle opener here.
Well, let's just ignore the wax and try opening it.
Okay.
Holy shit, 12% alcohol by volume.
No, I saw it. I was like, oh, no. First thing in the morning, 12%. Oh, my God. Oops. Well, it's definitely taking the wax off. Hope it doesn't fall down in the beer. Think it'll make us hallucinate?
That extra flavor.
You might need it, buddy.
It's made by Excel Brewing Company out of Breeze, Illinois.
Yep.
They also make ski soda, which I don't care for.
I like ski, but I'm not gonna sit there and act like it's the best fucking best soda on the fucking planet. Here I'm talking away from the mic like I ain't never done this before. Is it bad? It's like the inside of the cap is rusted.
That's extra flavor, I guess.
I mean, look. The fucking cap's rusted.
How long has this been sitting there?
I don't fucking know. It was on their release.
Holy shit, it is.
It was on their, like... it says January 2020.
I'm sure it'll be fine. Little rust never hurt anyone.
I mean, you up to date on your tetanus shots?
No.
Neither am I. Well, that's kind of scary, but I guess we'd be a couple pussies if we abort it now, huh? We're already recording. Ooh, them pussies won't drink because there's rust in it. And here, when there's people that are actually into brewing and know what's going on, are like, no, don't drink it. Are you fucking crazy?
You'll die.
No, you can't do that. And we're going to be like, well, we don't know what we're doing. All right, I'm going to pour this.
Anyway, this is a pumpkin ale brewed with cinnamon, nutmeg, clove, and allspice, and then aged in añejo tequila barrels.
All right, give me your skull glass. I have a bad feeling about this, buddy. We need a bigger fucking studio. Get out of my face. All right, here, that's yours. We'll take pictures of the bottle later. Got it.
Yep. Spill beer all over this shit.
God damn it. All right. Sorry. All right.
Consummate professionals we are.
We are professional. I'm not, I'm going to be honest, Brennan. It's, 11:30? It's 11:30, and I'm starting off with a 12% beer.
That's all right. You can drink beer before noon. You got to wait till noon before you switch over to liquor.
Oh,
otherwise,
so this
you're alcoholic.
Well, I thought that it was only acceptable to drink any alcoholic beverage before noon if you were camping. Because when you're camping, you're pretty much acting like a homeless person. And homeless people drink 24/7.
Yeah.
But it is Saturday, so I guess this is acceptable. This were our job, and we got paid to do this. This would be unacceptable this early, I would think, from a business aspect. A lot of people drink after lunch at work, right?
Do they? I don't know.
Not that I have.
No one I know.
I'm just speculating. I've never done that. I'm just speculating. I've never gone back to work drunk before. All right, let's try this fucking thing.
Okay.
Oh, it doesn't smell.
Smells like rust?
Yeah, it does. Smells like I'm going to be drinking the 10 man's piss. Sorry.
That's not bad.
Yeah, it's not as bad as I thought. I taste... Mm. I don't know what I taste.
Tastes like cookies. Is that the nutmeg?
Yeah, that's what I taste. No, yeah, it tastes like
like Christmas cookies or something?
Something like that. Yeah, I'm getting like the gingerbread man.
Yeah, ginger.
Is there gingerbread in this? Yeah, it's exactly what it tastes like. It tastes like gingerbread.
What's in gingerbread?
Ginger and bread. Well. Duh.
Is there nutmeg and cinnamon and gingerbread?
I don't know. Look it up.
That's what I'm doing.
I have no idea. I know they're delicious.
Ginger, honey, molasses.
Maybe it's the rust that's giving it that little bit of a Christmas taste. Yeah, it's definitely not as bad as I thought it was going to be. I was actually really scared of the tequila barrel.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm not tasting any tequila flavor at all.
No, I'm not either, and I don't really taste pumpkin either, though. Do you?
No, I don't think so.
They should have seriously named this Bruja Gingerbread Ale. But Excel to me is piss poor brewing anyways.
Really?
Yeah, I've never been a fan. Sorry, fellas. Not like you're listening anyways. Nobody's listening. I would rather drink their fucking sodas than their beer. How about that?
Yeah. I don't know if I've ever had any of their other beers.
I have, but it's just not impressive. And if I remember correctly, the head brewer at that 4204,
yeah,
I think he came from Excel.
Yeah.
Which is another reason all of 4204's beers are fucking mediocre. I think Excel's beers are mediocre. I got this one only because it said pumpkin ale and it had a cool-looking witch and a pumpkin. The label's cool as shit.
Yeah.
The bottle's cool. What they were going for, good idea. And I'm not going to even say it was poorly executed. I'm just going to say I don't taste pumpkin at all.
Nuh-uh.
But it's not a bad-tasting beer. So they'll get points on that. But I would rather drink one of their sodas over their beer. That's just me. So I'm going to... what, you got something to say?
No, I'm looking at what other beers Excel makes.
Tell me what they are, because I really don't remember. I only know them for their fucking soda, to be honest with you. I know more about their soda line than I do their beer.
I got Lefty's Lager.
Okay.
Bo's Dragon.
Sure.
Southside Stout.
Yep.
Eastside IPA.
Okay.
Flashbang.
Oh, yeah. Nice.
It is.
Make, does that make your stomach get a flashbang where you shit it all out like water?
Then they got seasonal beers. Happy Valentine, something or other. El Pistolero. Piesa Pilsner, Oktoberfest, Winter Warmer. I don't know.
Okay.
They got one that's Friday the 13th, kind of like Friday the 13th.
I got it. I got the joke.
Yeah.
Is it as scary as the movie?
I don't know. I clicked on it and the website wouldn't load, so I said fuck it.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't know. They got some other ones and it's too hard to read the names on the label, so... I'm bored of this conversation, so I'm not going to try to read any of this.
Okay, let's move on. So, I bought my daughter a fish tank.
Oh, you did?
Last week.
Fuck you.
Why?
Because my last fish died. I was going to give you my fish tank.
Oh, sorry, buddy. Travis told me the same thing. He's like, why didn't you tell me I could have given you a fish tank? I'm like, motherfucker, now everybody's giving me fish tanks. I have to go and fucking spend $50 on one. What's wrong with you?
You can have three fish tanks.
I don't want three. I just need the one, one and done. I didn't know you even had fish in yours because the water's black.
Well, I don't know how many fish I've had over the last 2 years, probably like 40.
Because you can't see in it?
You can't, no.
Because you don't take care of it? Okay, go ahead. Continue.
No, I clean it all the or used to clean it all the time.
That fucking fish was swimming in sewage, Brendan.
But yeah, I mean, you get 5 or 10 fish at a time and then they slowly die and whatnot.
Yeah.
But like we got a Placostomus, which is a little sucker fish that's... We got that like 2 years ago when we first got the fish tank, and he just died like a week ago.
Oh, so he's...
But he lasted the whole time. All the other fish are like, I'm checking out.
How long did the fish last on average?
I mean, some of them would die after a couple of days, but then some of them would last several months.
Okay.
But, yeah.
The end result is I'm going to be going through fish.
Yeah. Yeah. It's kind of annoying because we got the fish tank to entertain the cats.
Yeah.
And they didn't give a shit.
So then you're forced to have a whole ecosystem and take care of it like you're God. And you were a piss poor God, but I've looked in that tank. That was some murky ass fucking water, dude. Some murky ass water.
It was clean, but then.
But then you, just like any other God, you just gave up and you're like, fuck this. They're on their own. And then what happens when that happens? Everything goes to shit. God damn it, Brennan.
But, yeah. So I thought the cats would like sit there and look at the fish and be interested in them, but they weren't. All they wanted to do is stand on top of the fish tank, which I don't want them breaking the...
Right, falling in there.
And falling in. So had to yell at them whenever they jumped on the fish tank. And then they just didn't even care to look at the fish, watch them swimming around or anything.
Really?
Yeah, so...
That was a bust.
Yeah.
So my kid wanted one. She had a hermit crab. It finally bit the dust. It lasted a couple years. I threw him in the trash. She wasn't too happy about that. She's screaming at me. We're supposed to bury it. I was like, he will be buried in the dump whenever he gets to the landfill. But so we bought her a fish tank, and I didn't know how much preparation it is to do.
It's a fucking pain in the ass.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was not thrilled about it.
What'd you think you did? Just put water in, put some fish in, you good to go?
Fuck yeah.
That's what I thought also. No.
No, you got to put this chemical in it. And you got to put this chemical in it for 7 days. Then you need to bring your water up here and get it tested to make sure it's not going to fucking die. You could put fish in 24 hours after, but we recommend a week. But you can, but you don't have to. You can do this, but don't. I was like, what the fuck? I just want to get water in a tank and put fish in it.
I know.
So I followed the fucking instructions for the week.
Uh-huh.
So she's had a fucking tank in her room with no fish in it.
Yeah.
Whatever. Going and treating it every goddamn day like I'm supposed to. Now that it's up and running and good, I don't have to do it for another month.
Uh-huh.
So I took the water in this morning. Guy tested. He's like, everything's looking good, blah, blah, blah. Just so you know, the first fish you buy are probably going to die. He's like, it's nothing you did wrong. It's just going to happen. I'm like, okay. And then what? They're magically fine after that? I don't get it. I don't get that process. Okay, whatever. I said, so how about I get some cheap-ass fish? And so if they die, I'm not out a bunch of money.
Yeah.
I was like, how about you just give me some of them goldfish? He's like, nope. He's like, you don't want those. He's like, they're going to get really big, and they're going to shit everywhere.
Yeah.
I'm like, fuck. They're like 39 cents. I'm like, fuck. I don't want to get a bunch of them. I just wanted to make sure they survived the process.
Uh-uh.
So I got these little bitty fucking, I don't know what they are. They're fucking tiny. They're like $2 a piece.
Yeah.
He said they're pretty tough. He's like, they'll most likely survive the process, blah, blah, blah. I want to get her one of the glow fish, you know what I mean? The ones that are the neon ones. Because that's the kind of tank she got. But I'm not spending $8 a fish for him to be dead in a week.
Yeah.
I want to test the waters with a lower kind. And so I bought two of those, and then he's like, oh, you're going to want to get one of these snails and to eat the algae off the tank. Uh-huh.
That's what we got the Plecosmus for, the sucker fish.
The sucker fish. Yeah. And Travis told me not to get the sucker fish.
Really?
Because he said they're cool and everything, but he's like, he said that they just shit so much.
Oh, really?
That's why he just suggested not to get it.
I don't know.
So I was like, all right, so I got these snails. I got a snail put in there, and he's going to eat all the algae off the tank. Whatever. But, so I guess I'll wait a week and see what happens. If they survive, then I'll go get more fish.
Yeah.
So I'm halfway there. I'm halfway going to PetSmart. I want to talk about something here. I'm halfway there, and then I realize that we need masks to get in the fucking store.
Oh. Really?
Yes.
In PetSmart?
Yes.
You need masks to get in the store?
Correct. Big sign out front.
Oh.
We require a mask.
And what are they going to do if you walk in without a mask?
Feed you to the tigers they have in the back? I don't know. I look at her, I go, did you bring your mask? Because I have one in my car. I keep my stupid fucking thing in my armrest. No. So I fucking turn around and go all the way back home to get it.
Yeah.
Go back up there. So I'm like pissed off. I'm so fucking sick of this mask. The bullshit.
Yup.
I am I don't under. Here's my thing. I'm not a doctor, though. My grandpa and my uncle were doctors, so that pretty much makes me a doctor, right?
Yeah. I think you just need to go down to the medical school and say, "Hey, my grandpa and uncle,
correct,
they were doctors,
both so, blood,
yeah,
relatives."
And they're like, "Oh, here."
And then I just have to fill out a form, and I'm a doctor, right?
Yeah, and they'll give you your medical license,
Dr. Smitty.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, that's what I'm getting.
Okay,
at.
But you're not officially.
Though. Not officially. I need to do that.
Okay,
but we're still gonna call me Dr. Smitty.
Okay.
All right.
Yes.
If I am correct, and I'm not gonna. Aren't viruses like a non-living?
Yes.
Thing.
Yeah.
It's something your cells do to create it. It's not like bacteria or fungal or it's not a living organism.
Correct.
In the sense.
It's, yeah.
So how the fuck are you going to catch a virus? How many times have you been to the fucking doctor? You're like, I feel like shit. I'm doing this. It's upper respiratory, or I'm doing this. And they go, oh, it's a virus. There's nothing we can do. You just got to wait it out because there's nothing they can give you to kill it because it's not a living thing. I know in the grand scheme of things, everything's living because it's something's happening. But it's not like if I have a cold and I fucking sneeze in your face, that living shit that's in me just transferred over to you. This is a whole cellular.
I tried looking up if a virus was. I don't know. I looked it up before and it was confusing. And
it is confusing.
It depends on what definition of living or life you use. And,
right.
I don't know.
But I was always going to understand because if it's viral, you can't catch it. It's just something you got to fucking deal with. It's non-contagious, in other words.
No. I mean, there's actual little viruses that can go from one person to another and you can get it from. But it's not like alive. I don't know. It's weird. I'm confused.
It's just either way. I'm tired of wearing a mask.
Okay. Here's what you do. When you go to PetSmart,
yes,
and there's a sign on the door that says they require masks, you just ignore that sign.
And just walk in?
Walk into PetSmart, grab what you need, walk up to the front counter. Everyone gives you dirty looks. pay for your goods, and then leave.
Just leave?
Yep.
Okay. All right.
Stay away from people. Don't go
breathing
in people's face. Piss them off.
Right. Here's what I've learned in this whole thing.
Yep.
Not only have I learned that people are batshit crazy and afraid of everything because they watch too much media and Facebook and this and that, and they believe anything. They believe anything. And
some people probably believe you're a doctor.
I am a doctor.
Okay.
Dr. Smitty. I'm going to be in so much trouble. I specialize in breast exams, though. That's not viruses.
Not checking for breast cancer or anything, just...
No, I do check for that.
Oh, I thought you were just...
Anything breast, I can diagnose that shit.
People had breasts?
That, too.
Oh, that's... Yeah.
I mean, I can. I don't want to check if males got them, but...
Well, I mean, you visually check. It's like, no.
Oh, yeah, but visually, for sure.
Okay.
God didn't give me eyes to not use them, buddy. I'm not fucking blind yet. Anyways, like I was saying... I don't remember what I was saying. All right, I was bitching about the mask.
People are batshit crazy.
People are crazy. If you... Okay, look, my perspective. I'm not afraid to get sick. So I don't have a problem going out and getting a mask. I know I'm at risk, but I'm at risk for anything when you're out in public.
Yeah.
Anything.
Like in winter, in cold and flu season.
Anything.
Whatever.
Okay. I'm prepared for that. If I wasn't prepared for that, if I didn't think that couldn't happen, then I guess I would never go out. But you can't do that. You have to live your life. You can't be a shut-in. Can't do this, can't do that. Now, I do agree with some of the things they've done. Putting the big plastic shields up at the gas station or anywhere.
Yeah.
So I'm okay with that because people are dirty motherfuckers. And if I was the one working back behind there, I'd probably just want that in general because people are fucking nasty. And I don't want them breathing in my fucking face. Even before this all happened, it was probably a good idea to put that up there because people are disgusting.
That's true. But I was thinking, like, in not-so-good areas, like in East St. Louis.
Okay.
Like, all the gas stations and fast food restaurants, they already got like bulletproof glass.
Correct.
And they're like, fuck, we've been doing that for years.
We've been doing that for fucking 30 years. Correct. Like, yeah, you go through the drive-thru and you don't even see anybody.
Really?
I've been down there and I've been through a drive-thru. It was a big metal, like half circle. When you get up after you order and you get up there, and all it does is spin. And then it opens up and you have to put your money in and it spins around. And it spins back around again and it's open and your food's there. You never see a person, so you can't rob them in the drive-thru. So it's like, yes, some of that stuff, yeah, I agree. It's that's not a bad thing because, like I said, people are dirty. Here's the stupid thing. You're going to the store, right? They're like, oh, Snooks, you got to wear a mask. You got to wear a fucking mask in here, you goddamn criminal. Then they got these fucking plastic things up in front of the cashiers. Why the cashiers are taking my food and touching it and then putting it in a bag for me to go home. What are we solving? Oh, no, you're supposed to go home and wipe everything down. Fuck you. Fuck you. That's impossible. So look at that aspect. Think about everything you do. Everything you do and touch from the moment you get up to the moment you go to bed. Can you stop from getting sick or anything? No, it's impossible. You're either going to fucking get something or you're not. But that's just the way it is. You cannot avoid it.
And also, when you're paying for your food, if you pay with money, that's like the dirtiest shit ever.
Correct.
Everybody's been touching it.
Money is fucking disgusting.
And it's always been that way.
Yes.
Not that that many people pay with actual money anymore, but...
No, but when, even fucking...
And it's always been that way.
It's always been the most dirtiest thing on the fucking planet. And guess what? We have survived. And don't you want to be out in the open so your immune system can build and be strong and maybe not get that kind of thing? Or would you want to live in a cave so when you do have to go out, damn, you get everything known to man because your fucking body ain't ready for it?
I got a whole thing about that in just a second.
Okay.
But you were saying you go home and wipe down all your food and whatnot?
I do not do that. But
Well, that's what you're supposed to do.
Correct.
I was, I don't know, watching something on TV where people were disinfecting the school with big sprayers and, like, spraying all the bookshelves and whatnot.
Okay.
And so anybody that touches the books, there's no viruses on them because they were sprayed.
Okay.
But, I mean, with a book's on a bookshelf...
How's it going to get a virus on it?
Well, no. I mean, somebody just read the book, flipped through the pages, put it back in there, and then they spray the bookshelf where the... binding of the book is facing. The binding of the book doesn't
have any viruses. But the pages are full of viruses?
Every single page has viruses. So the next person that picks it up...
still getting it.
Unless they only touch the fucking...
Yes, it's, edge of the book. It's ridiculous.
I know, it's...
it's ridiculous. It's
like, there's fucking 30 books on this bookshelf. They just sprayed the fucking...
you know what I've been doing?
And,
so when I get home from the grocery store, I set all my food on the ground. I take a flamethrower to it. I just... I burn the viruses off of it. It ruins my food.
Well,
but hey, guess who's not getting sick, motherfucker? Joke's on all of you.
Kill two birds with one stone.
Fuck yeah, my chicken's ready,
it's
buddy.
It's already cooked.
It's already cooked. Put it right in the fucking refrigerator.
So anyway, the thing about having an immune system.
Yes.
I've never fucking understood why people use hand sanitizer.
I hate it.
It's dumb and terrible.
It stinks.
Wait. Like
regular hand sanitizer, I cannot stand the fucking smell
of it. Oh, really?
No, it makes me want to gag.
Yeah.
Seriously, I've never liked it. For that reason. One, I don't like anything I put on my hand, and it, like, is wet and jelly, and then it dissolves instantly. That's I don't like that. That's weird, all right? That's weird. And it smells. It makes me want to fucking puke when I smell it. I've always thought that. And my wife does it all the time. You want hand sanitizer? Nope. Not touching that. I don't like it.
Anyway, I'm not a doctor.
I am.
Okay. But my theory for, like, the last 25 years is when people started using hand sanitizer, because, like, it wasn't a thing when we were little kids.
Oh, yeah, we didn't. That shit didn't exist.
That you use that and it kills all the whatever, bacteria, viruses, or whatnot.
Probably even the shit that's helping you protect against that.
Well, that, and so you never get any bacteria, viruses, germs in your body, so your immune system cannot build up a immunity tolerance
Correct.
To said germs. So when it does when he does get a sick, then you're fucked.
You're sick.
Your immune system sucks.
How often are you sick, Brennan?
Me, never.
Me neither.
Because I don't use hand sanitizer. I don't wash my hands.
I like doorknobs on purpose.
Oh, I don't do that.
I do.
But nearly as often as I ought to.
What, like doorknobs?
No, wash my hands nearly as often. But
let me ask you. So you get colds, I'm sure.
Every so often.
Probably once a year. Get your standard cold, maybe a sore throat, cough, whatever, sniffles. I get that. I can't tell you the last time I had the flu. Actually, I want to say the last time I had the flu, I guess it was the flu because I fucking puked when I woke up in the morning and I just shit my brains out the rest of the day. Was probably over 10 years ago.
Yeah.
Over 10 years ago. Ever since then, it's all been self-induced by alcohol.
Yeah.
I'll get my sore throats, my coughs once a year, and that's it. But I don't get the fucking flu. Do you get flu shots?
No.
Fuck no. I think that's ridiculous. I think that's part of the fucking problem. And I'm not an anti-vaxxer at all. I'm not against. I think the shit they give you when you're a kid is probably pretty legit. Is there side effects? Yes. It's man-made shit. There's always going to be side effects. There's always going to be repercussions when we're doing this. Well, we never had this much autism since, you know, you started doing that from babies. Well, you know what? It could be a fucking side effect. I'm not going to say it isn't. Maybe it is. And that's just, it sucks. But look at all the shit that we've wiped out because of it.
Yeah.
But other than that, that's the only ones I've had. I don't get fucking flu shots. I don't do that. So it's like, there's probably some that are important and worth the risk. And then you got the ones now, like, make sure you get your flu shot. Nope, I'm okay. I'm good. When they come out with this fucking fake vaccine for this fucking COVID bullshit, I'm not getting it. Fuck you. I don't need your bullshit, because guess what? I guarantee I'm not going to get this fucking stupid thing.
Or you will get it and it won't affect you because
I'm healthy.
You have an immune system.
Correct.
Because you don't use hand sanitizer.
So do you know anybody that's gotten it? Physically known somebody that's been tested positive. We'll just say that. Out of this whole time, this all started for us in March.
Guy I work with, his wife apparently had it. So he was off work for a couple weeks, and then he was back, and he never said that his wife, you know, died. So I'm assuming she got over it.
So I know one person that tested positive for it.
Yeah.
An actual person I actually physically know. Someone in his department got it somehow, whatever. So they made everybody go get tested, and he tested positive, and his old lady tested positive.
Uh-huh.
And he was actually supposed to be at Bill's 3rd of July party.
Yeah.
He wasn't there because of that.
Yeah.
I talked to another buddy about it. We were, like, talking back and forth. And he goes, he tested positive for it. And he said, so now he had to, like, stay home for, like, 2 weeks. They both had to, like, quarantine or whatever. And he said he had one day where he had a little fever. He goes, that was it. That was it. So it's like, you know, somebody with a compromised immune system, is that going to affect him worse? Of course it is. Is the cold going to affect him worse? Of course it is. So it's like, what are we shutting down everything for? What are we destroying everybody's livelihoods for people that are, if you're older over a certain age and they say you're high at risk, then you should be smart enough to not go out. The rest of us, who cares?
Yep.
Who cares? Do you think we're going to shut the state down again?
I quit paying attention to all that. But according to what Casey says, yeah.
Yeah, I get. So I haven't been paying attention to that shit either. I like just pretty much have ignored it. But I have caught little articles here and there. I see pop up. I don't read them, but I just see the headlines, and like it seems like it's leaning that way again. Which most of like, so everything's shut down. Everybody's gone through the same shit. Everybody that's listening, everybody's gone through the same bullshit. So in Illinois, because we're on the Illinois, we're basically in St. Louis, but we're on the Illinois side, just right over the river. So Illinois finally opened up their shit at the end of June. where restaurants can open back up. And have you noticed most of them still aren't letting people in?
Aren't they? I
no.
haven't gone out, so I don't know.
The only place that I know of for a fact that lets you in is that Mexican place we're going to go to today.
Yeah.
That, was it Rio Grande?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, our sushi place that we go to, still only doing carry out.
Yeah.
All the fast food's still doing carry out, at least in this area.
Yeah.
If I'm in Highland working, I can go right into the restaurant, sit down and eat.
Really?
I don't give a fuck. I mean, they got it all spaced out where you can only sit here, here, here. But, like, you can't do that around here. It's like people are still just staying closed. And I get why fast food's doing it, because they're not hurting.
Yeah.
They're like, you know what? Fuck it. We don't got to clean. We don't got to do shit. Just do the drive through. I mean, they don't clean anyways, but I mean, they don't have to wipe down their tables and section shit off. Fuck it. Just have them keep the drive through. So I see why they're doing it. But like these sit down restaurants where you thrive on getting people in there, I don't know why you're not fucking opening up. I mean, ugh. I'm just over it. And I'm sure people are half and half with them. So there's people are like, I'm sure 50% is over it, and the other 50% is like, no, we gotta fucking shut her down because they're so scared. What do you think the percentage is in your head of people that realize this is bullshit to the percentage of people that are just fucking terrified of it and just want to do whatever the media fucking tells them to? Do you think it's a 50-50?
I don't think there's only two options there. There's people that are think this probably bullshit, but like, well, in case it isn't, let's play it safe.
Well, let's break it down more. Yeah, because there's probably several ways you can look. I'm just saying, because I'll wear a mask when I go out. I think it's bullshit, but I'm still going to wear my mask because I don't want to cause trouble.
Yeah.
That's just me. I'm an introvert. I don't want anybody to say anything to me. I don't even want anybody to say hi to me. So let alone, I don't want somebody to give me dirty looks, because you keep giving me dirty looks, then I'm probably going to open my fucking mouth and it's not going to be good. So I play nice. I don't like doing that. I feel like I'm being a sheep and just following. You know, the best way I can describe this is what this reminds me of when I go into, I'm going to use Schnucks as an example because I grocery shop there every week. And I think this every fucking time I'm in there. Walk in, watching everybody with their fucking mask on. They got the aisles where you can only go down one way, which half the people aren't fucking following it anyways.
Well, I mean, half the time, the people put the stickers, the arrows in the wrong direction.
Really?
Yeah, because when I'm walking down and only half the time the arrows are going in the right direction, because I'm never going in the wrong direction.
Correct.
The arrows are wrong.
The arrows are wrong. I get what you're saying. They put the do not walk this way backwards.
Yeah.
I get you. I've seen that. I'm like, well, they got this wrong.
Because I'm going this way.
Because I'm going, they don't get it. But no, you got this backwards. So it's funny, though, because I didn't even realize Snooks did that. Because think about it. We are, in our brains, we have been going to the grocery store for eons. And you just go down whatever aisle, whenever you need, you get it, no big deal. And now you have to go certain ways? Dude, we ain't made for that. I'm halfway down the aisle, and I'm like, what the fuck is everybody coming at me for? And I'm like, oh, man, they got these signs backwards. And these idiots don't know it. Anyways, I go to Schnucks. I play by the rules. I put on the damn mask. I'm walking around looking at everybody. Everybody's just... Ugh, makes me sick. And over the intercom, you got this music playing, and then every so often this guy interrupts in his nicest voice, be sure to social distance and blah blah blah, make sure you got your mask on. It reminds me of a 1980s dystopian future movie, sci-fi movie, you know what I mean? Like They Live or Escape from New York, any of that shit. And it's like, oh my god, how has this really come true? How has this come true? This is happening.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, wow. Super professional. Fucking professional.
This happened last month also. Who the fuck is calling me?
Brennan, everybody
someone
knows.
Someone from San Antonio, Texas.
You should probably answer that.
I don't know anyone in San Antonio.
Dude, it's important. Maybe it's your brother.
What? Why is he in San Antonio?
Who knows?
He got kidnapped?
Yes. He got kidnapped.
I hung up. I'll turn my ringer off.
Yeah, that's probably a good idea. It was a ransom because he got kidnapped.
Well, I'm busy.
Did he get kicked off of Facebook for a while?
Yeah.
Okay, I figured. I just saw him come back on. I'm like, oh, yeah, I haven't seen Damien in a while. Yeah, he must have got kicked off for a while. Was it a 30-day?
I don't know.
Had to have been. Cause it's
Are you not friends with his alter ego?
Which one's his alter ego?
Damiano?
I guess not.
Yeah. Yeah, because
he's... That son of a bitch.
Oh.
I'm going to have words with him. Unless I am, I unfollowed him a long time ago.
Yeah.
Oh. I'll talk to that motherfucker. I'll see what's going on, why he's hiding from me. But it's funny, I didn't realize he had disappeared. And then now I just week, I saw him pop back on. I'm like, oh, he must have been gone for 30 days. We were just talking about that last night. So we got into a discussion of the mask and all this shit because we went out to, well, we went to buy this excellent beer and pick up some sushi for dinner. And I told the old lady, I was like, God, I'm so sick of this. I'm just so sick. This is the worst year ever, at least in our lifetime. And to me, it's like nothing's really happening. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
I mean, they act like people are just dropping dead. Are they? I don't see it.
No.
I don't see anything.
Hold on, I just looked it up. But fuck.
And I'm next to a major fucking city, so don't act like I'm in the middle of fucking Wyoming in some little fucking 2,000 people, population. Where yeah, it's probably nothing's really gonna happen there. I'm right next to St. Louis. I'm in the fucking metroplex of St. Louis.
Like whatever happened in Italy.
Don't hear about it no more.
Yeah, what the fuck happened?
I just thought about that yesterday.
It was like,
the world was ending there. And I have no doubt that people were fucking dying. I live there. Well, like, we both live there. I understand how they live on top of one another. And it is an older population.
Yeah.
So I get it. But as bad as it was, and they shut that whole fucking country down, it was, oh my God.
And like, I actually shut it down.
Yes, like really shut it down. Not like the pretend shit that they've been doing in the States here. Really shut that country down. And then all of a sudden, nothing. I haven't heard nothing about Italy in months.
Either everyone got better.
Or they are all dead.
Everybody died.
Well, they can't have all died because I still follow Flesh God Apocalypse. Yeah. And they do a I think it's every weekend, at least once a week. They all like do like a video chat, and I think they kind of do something like talk and this and that. So, I mean, they're still alive. And they just posted their European tour that's happening later this year. So hopefully they'll be back. Because that was a show that got canceled on my ass. Yeah. That's the one I got all those tickets for.
Oh.
So hopefully they'll be back in 2001, and we got some tickets to go up there and see them. When I get them, because I got that free money from them. But you know, yeah, I just thought about that. What happened? Are they okay? Are they all dead?
Because the hospitals were apparently overflowing.
Right. They said patients. They were just like chucking bodies on the sidewalks because they had nowhere to go with them. And now they're like, what? What are you looking at us for? Is that. What's real and what isn't? You know what I mean? That's why I turned all that shit off. Turned it off. I don't know. It's insanity. It's insanity. Why worry about it? Go out and live your fucking life. And I'm most pissed off about, and I thought about this on the way over here. When's the last time we went to a fucking show? I want to cry, Brendan.
Yeah.
You know what's going to happen? The first metal concert... No matter who it is, it could be Mortician. It's sold out already. Mortician comes to St. Louis next weekend, sold out. Because people are going to be dying to get into that motherfucker, no pun intended. They're going to be dying to get into see a show.
Mortician's going to sell out Riverport.
Yes. I believe they'd be able to do it at this point in time. Play World Damnation.
We already played that one.
Haven't you been paying attention?
Play it again. Oh, man, what a show.
Totally did not play that song.
They did not play that song. It was the only reason we were there.
It's the only song I knew by him.
Yeah, it's what the fuck. Fuck you guys. You didn't play it. Lying assholes. They're like, it's the only song anybody knows us by. We're not playing it. They're one of those bands. Everybody wants to hear the classics, and they're like, fuck you. We're not playing them. Ugh. All right. Dr. Smitty is getting hungry.
Okay.
So we need to play some music so Dr. Smitty can get something to eat.
Oh.
Oh, what's wrong with us today? This fucking beer has made us angry, buddy.
Tequila makes me or even.
Tequila makes me angry.
I don't think there's any tequila in that, though. It's just Asian tequila.
I'm trying to make excuses.
Oh, okay.
The doctor has spoken.
Dr. Smitty.
Dr. Smitty says tequila. The listeners aren't feeling well. We need to give them a dose of some music.
Okay.
And yes.
Yes. And tequila anger.
So we are going
blood.
To anal probe
Whoa,
somebody.
No.
Yes, I'm a doctor. That's what I do.
That's an alien, not a doctor.
Man, I got some weird doctors. I got some weird doctors.
Okay. This is the worst segue into music ever.
No, it's not.
Okay, we're going to play The Outsider by Defiant Brood. Go. The Outsider by Defiant Brood. They are from Cumberland, Maryland. You can find them at defiantbrood.bandcamp.com.
Right on. It was Sari's birthday this past week, so happy birthday. That is the singer.
Happy birthday to her.
Yes.
What day was her birthday?
I don't know.
Yeah,
I don't remember.
It was my birthday a week ago.
It wasn't the same day.
Yeah.
No, it was this past week.
Yeah.
Was it yours on this past week, too?
Yeah, a week
oh,
ago.
Fuck, happy birthday, Brendan.
Happy birthday to me.
Shit.
And her.
It wasn't the same day. Facebook told me.
Yeah, okay.
I can barely remember my own birthday.
Happy birthday to everyone.
Everybody. Happy birthday, everybody.
Happy birthday, Steve.
Thanks, buddy.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. Happy birthday to the members of Memories of a Dead Man.
Happy birthday, fellas.
This is their song, Inner Shout.
Let's go!
That was Inner Shout by Memories of a Dead Man. They are from Gay Paris, Paris, France. Yes. You can find them at memoriesofadeadman.bandcamp.com.
Don't give me shit about not saying happy birthday to you. I said happy birthday on Facebook. I didn't even get a like from it.
There was like fucking 27 people.
Motherfucker, I'm important.
Oh.
You go through the 27 people and you go, where's Smitty at? Like. You don't have to respond, but you have to like. But you didn't like or respond. You didn't even get on there and be like, thanks everybody for the birthday wishes. I'm an asshole.
Yeah, I don't use the Facebooks. Well, actually, I do.
But you do too. Don't. You're on there creeping, motherfucker. Don't.
Yeah, well, yeah, I spy on people. I don't want people talking to me or anything like that. I don't want to communicate with another human being. I like spy on people and yeah.
All right, creeper.
That's what I do. Yeah.
God damn it.
Anyway, this is Lying to Yourself by Roses Unread. Roses Unread with their song Lying to Yourself. They are from Tennessee. You can find them at rosesunreadofficial.com.
Check them out.
Yep.
So this next one I was very excited for.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm actually a fan of this band.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you know that because I got a fucking decal on my car.
Yep.
And my motorcycle.
Ooh.
So I've been a fan of these guys for a while. So when I got a promo from the record label to play it on the show, I was super excited.
That's a brand new song?
Brand new album. I got the whole.
Oh, a whole album?
Yeah. When you get promos, let me explain how this works. Mm-hmm. When these and I don't understand how this works 100%. So there were some labels in the beginning when we started this podcast that I got a hold of and got asked to be put on their promo stuff. And they'll do it. Now I get promos from all these underground labels, and I don't know how the fuck that even happens. Because I didn't ask for all of them. But I get them, and I'm not complaining. So, and we've talked about this on the show before. We prefer to play actual submitted songs from unsigned independent artists.
Yeah, let me interrupt you real quick. I just liked your post on Facebook from a week ago.
Nice, thank you.
Now, continue with what you were saying.
You know, those will always get the independent bands, the unsigned bands sending us their stuff. They'll always get top priority.
Yeah.
Promos from independent labels, which I have no problem dealing with because they're small independent labels, I use them for fillers because we don't always have a lot of submissions. And I get promo after promo after promo daily. Oh, like, dude. So many. So when I see bands I actually know and listen to, and this next one being it, I was just like, holy shit. And I just read on their Instagram that their pre-orders for this album is going to come out next week.
Yeah.
So I was like, oh, sweet, because I'm going to buy, I'll buy a vinyl copy of it. And I was like, all right, cool. I knew they were working on a new album. I knew it was about ready. So they announced that the pre-orders will be coming next week. And then all of a sudden, lo and behold, I get a promo. And when I get promos, they give me the whole albums. It's not just songs.
Yeah.
They send me the whole record. The label does. So these labels are, or these songs or the albums are watermarked. So if I like would take them and then put them online for people to pirate, they'll know where the fuck it came from. Which obviously I don't do that. I use them for show purposes only. But it is always nice for bands that I didn't even realize that this band was on that small of a label.
Yeah.
I was like, oh shit. Because I'm just a fan of them. I just came across them somewhere or another and I started listening to them and really liked them. We got their new one sent to us. I got to check out the whole album and I'm very happy with it. And I can't wait for the pre-order to come out this week so I can get my vinyl copy on order.
Anyway, this is the band Iwata with the song Jin. that was the song Gin by Iwata. It is on Eisenwald Records. Got a new record coming out next week. Whatever Steve said, next month, I don't know.
They don't have the release date yet. They haven't announced it. The pre-orders will start next week.
Pre-order next week. There you go.
I follow him on Instagram.
Okay.
I'm sure I like him on Facebook, too. Just look up Uada, U-A-D-A, on Instagram, yeah, and you'll find their stuff, and they'll have links to all their shit there. Good band. Great. We saw them live.
I saw them live.
Yeah, they're good.
There's lots of smoke involved.
Yes.
Like you couldn't see anything.
Right. Couldn't see them. They're just silhouettes the entire time. Yeah. They're a good band. I like them a lot. I'm excited to see them again.
See, what I wanted to do is... No, when there was so much smoke, you couldn't see a damn thing.
Right.
I wanted to round up everybody in the audience, and we could all sneak out the back door. Because they wouldn't be able to see anybody leaving.
Right.
And then when the show's over and there's nobody there, they'll be like, what happened?
What the fuck happened? Were we that bad?
But they wouldn't know everybody was leaving because there was a lot of smoke.
That's mean. Right?
There was like a lot of smoke.
Yeah, that's the gig. That's what they do. That's their stick.
Yep.
So
anyway, the name of the song is Gin.
Yes.
Like the juniper berry flavored alcoholic beverage.
Sure.
Gin.
No.
Oh, okay. DJIN. Okay. Because I don't know how to pronounce that word, so I just said gin.
Oh, yeah. I was going to ask you. I thought you knew how to pronounce it. Oh. I've seen that before with the D in front of it, and I'm like, I don't know.
I looked it up. It's some Arabic demon thing, but I assume it's pronounced gin.
Probably. Like, the D's probably silent. Like probably doesn't need to be there.
Fucking, yeah. I don't know.
I don't know, Brennan.
Gin.
I didn't write the song.
I'm just rambling.
Why?
We're already
an hour 18
in. Oh, fuck. The next song is Infesticide by Infesticide. This is Envenoming Wounds.
Bring another song for us to deliver. Nothing free.
That was Envenoming Wounds by the band Infesticide. They are on Blood Harvest Records. You can finally find their music on the internet somewhere.
Promo band.
Yeah.
That's why we don't know what's going on.
Yeah.
So give them the record label. You type the record label and you'll find them.
Blood Harvest Records.
There you go. You'll find them.
Go for it.
If you like the show, you can subscribe on iTunes, Google Play Music, Spotify, iHeartRadio, Stitcher, all sorts of good stuff. If you like us, go to Facebook and like our page. We are on Instagram, at Empathic Radio. I'm on Instagram, at Empathica Smitty. Not Dr. Smitty. It's Empathica Smitty.
Although he is a doctor.
I am a doctor. if you are in a metal, a punk, or a hardcore band and you want to submit your stuff, submit it to empathicradio@gmail.com. You can also hit us up on the same email address and we will send you stickers to the show. Other than that, let's do the last one and get the hell out of here.
Last song's by the band Soul Rot. They're on Memento Mori Records. Name of the song is Nihilistic Automata.
Looking for